I'm curious about CSS preprocessor languages like Sass, Less, Stylus, and PostCSS. Can you explain how they compare?
Sure. Let's start with Sass, which stands for Syntactically Awesome Style Sheets. It's one of the most popular CSS preprocessors. Sass allows you to use features like variables, nested rules, mixins, and functions. For instance, a basic example in Sass would look like this. This code sets a variable for the primary color and applies it to the body's color. When compiled, it becomes regular CSS.
I see. How about Less? How does it differ from Sass?
Less is similar to Sass in many ways. It also supports variables, mixins, functions, and nesting. However, its syntax is closer to CSS. Here's a similar example in Less. The key difference here is the syntax. Less maintains a more CSS-like syntax with semicolons and curly braces, which some developers find easier to grasp.
Interesting. What about Stylus? How does it fit into this?
Stylus offers even more flexibility in terms of syntax. It's known for being highly expressive and terse. It can omit semicolons, colons, and even braces, making the code look cleaner to some. Here's the same example in Stylus. Stylus syntax can be a bit harder to read for beginners, but it offers great flexibility for those who prefer a more concise style.
That's quite a difference in syntax. And what about PostCSS?
PostCSS is a bit different from the others. It's more of a tool than a language, which allows you to use JavaScript plugins to transform styles. Its core functionality is to parse CSS into an abstract syntax tree, AST, and then apply various transformations. Here's how you might use a PostCSS plugin in a JavaScript file. This example shows a PostCSS setup that uses the auto prefixer plugin to automatically add vendor prefixes to CSS rules. It's powerful because you can write standard CSS and then apply numerous transformations and optimizations.
I see. How do the outcomes of these preprocessors differ in the real world?
The main difference is in the development experience and the flexibility they offer. Sass and Less are quite similar, focusing on making CSS more maintainable and easier to write. Stylus offers more syntactical freedom, which can be either a pro or a con, depending on your team's preference.
What about compatibility and community support?
Sass probably has the largest community and the most resources. It's widely adopted in the industry. Less, while popular a few years ago, has seen a decline in usage, but still maintains good community support. Stylus has a smaller community, but is appreciated for its flexibility. PostCSS, being a tool rather than a language, is widely used in the industry for its plugin ecosystem and is supported by a large community of plugin developers. If you want a robust, industry-standard tool, Sass is a great choice. For a more CSS-like syntax, less is suitable. If you prefer a highly flexible and terse syntax, Stylus is the way to go. And if you need a powerful tool for CSS transformations and optimizations, PostCSS is unmatched.
Thank you. This comparison really helps understand the nuances of each option.
You're welcome. Experiment and see which one fits best for your workflow.